If you're looking for a great recipe for some collard greens, look no further. I have some collard greens with smoked turkey pieces and bacon. So we start out by having 4 bunches of greens. You can use as many or as little as you like according to the size of your family. And I have bought these from our local grocery store. I have 1 stick of unsalted butter. I also have my beef bacon for that extra flavor. And I have some smoked turkey wings, as well as my go-to seasoning blend of bell peppers and onions that I get out the frozen section at our grocery store. And I also have some minced garlic. Now you can add whatever meats that you like, or you can make this vegetarian by omitting the meat and just having the bell peppers and onions. So I begin by rinsing off my smoked turkey parts, and then I pour off the water, and then I refill up my pot with approximately half a pot of water, or either 3/4 of the pot is filled with water. And I'm going to cook these turkey parts covered for about a good hour and 10 minutes. I've measured out about 3/4 of a cup, almost a cup of those bell peppers and onions. And now is the time to start cleaning our greens. I use a half a cup of white distilled vinegar as well as salt. And instead of cutting my greens first, I like to wash my greens while it's at its whole state. This gives me the opportunity to make sure that I can look at each leaf, examining for any type of bugs or insects that might be caught up in there, and to make sure that each leaf is being washed carefully. This also allows me to make sure that all the dirt is removed off of the leaf and I'm not losing any of the vitamins and nutrients by cutting the greens first and placing them in the water. This method makes it so much easier. So what I'm also doing is wanting to make sure and test to see if your greens are nice and tender. You break the stem. If your stem snaps without any issue and has that popping sound, then you know your greens are good and tender. If your greens stem seems to be on the tough side where it bends like a weeping willow bush, then you know there's a possibility that your greens will not be that tender. Now you can work with them, but you might have to cook them a little longer than you want to. So I'm just examining each leaf here, and what I'm also doing is breaking off some of those stems. Now I do this method 4 times, as long as my greens are not super, super dirty, which they weren't here. If your greens are really dirty, then you might want to, you know, have to wash them 8 to 10 times like I have done in the past when I have purchased them straight from a farmer or a little, those little markets that be where people have, you know, selling different produce from the produce stands and stuff out in the country. But because I got these from the grocery store, I washed them 2 times with the salt and vinegar mixture, and then I rinsed them 2 times with just plain clear water. So after I did this method, I did it in portions so that way the water wasn't super filled with all the greens and I can inspect them, like I said, better. This is now the time where I'm going to be cutting my leaves of my greens, and I'm removing more of the stem because I don't want all of the stem to be in my green pot. Now, you know, each person is different. Some people don't mind the extra stems. I prefer more greens than stem. So I am just breaking off that middle part, not all the way to the top, but just enough. The leaves were quite tender and I really didn't have to cut them. If you want to use a knife to cut them, then go right ahead. I'm just going to put a few of the pieces of the leaves together, fold and roll, and I'd like to cut mine anywhere from 1/4 inch, no more than 1/2 inch. And I just kind of do a little julienne slice here, and they will be placed inside of a bowl. Now, some people like to break their greens, you know, the leaves of the greens and just kind of do like a rough break of them, like you would do lettuce. That's fine too. I just like to cut mine to have smaller pieces. But you know, you can cut your greens however you like. So I'm just repeating this method by removing the stem from the greens and just breaking it off. And then I'm going to slice them up and place them to the side. Now, if your leaves are pretty small, then you don't have to, you know, necessarily remove too much of the stem. You can just stack them up on top of each other and cut them in two or three portions. But these leaves were kind of on the larger side, so that's why the stems were removed as much as possible. And like I said, I'm just going to repeat this step by cutting them in a quarter of an inch to a half inch in width. And then they're going to be placed to the side. And this is what is left from those four bunches. Now I am going to cook about a good 5 to 6 pieces of the bacon. I kind of just cut them into pieces until they were crispy. And I'm going to set them to the side. I removed them from the skillet, from my pot. And I'm going to use that grease to saute my bell peppers and onions and my garlic. I'm using about a half a teaspoon of garlic. And once they cook for about 1 to 2 minutes, then I go ahead and I add my greens. Now, if you want, you can add another tablespoon of vegetable oil, of olive oil. I'm just adding my greens here, and then I'm going to mix that up with the bacon grease and the bell peppers and onions that is in it. I'm adding my seasonings, which is a little seasoning salt. You can season your greens according to your taste. I'm adding some hickory salt, and then I'm also going to add my Tony Sachery's Cajun seasoning. And this is just going to add so much flavor to your greens. And I'm going to also stir these up to make sure that all of the greens have and all the seasonings, you know, mix in with the greens, as well as pulling some of that bacon grease throughout those greens. Now, these greens will shrink on you. It seemed like a lot, but once they wilt down, it won't be probably more than 2 cups. So I'm just giving this a quick stir, and then I add my last portion. And this is what I'm doing right here. And you see how they have shrunk, that first portion there. Once I add my second portion of greens, I'm adding my 1 stick of unsalted butter. And then I'm going to pour my broth from my smoked turkey. Now, I have more broth than what I thought I would, so I did not add the whole portion. I've added probably about a good 4 to 5 cups of that smoked turkey broth, as well as the smoked turkey parts. And then this is going to cook covered for an additional 45 minutes to an hour. Now, the butter, as well as that smoked turkey, is going to just marinate all through those greens, adding so much flavor. Now, halfway through the cooking process, if you want, you can taste the broth and the juice from the greens to see if you might have to add a little bit more salt to it, or a little more seasoning. Mine turned out fine, but I didn't have to add any more. But I did do another stir and realized that my turkey was so tender, it was falling apart. And look at those greens. They look so beautiful. They are pretty much done. But what I wanted to do is let some of that broth cook down. So I covered the pot for an additional 10 to 15 minutes, but I left the pot lid cracked so some of that broth can evaporate from there. And once, if some of that broth had evaporated from the greens, then I topped my greens with some of that crispy beef bacon that I had removed earlier. And it allowed the greens to just kind of help the bacon hold its shape and not get too mushy. It gave it such a good texture. And boy, oh boy, I tell you, these greens were so good. I mean, that beef bacon flavor and those smoked turkey necks. This recipe is bomb. So, if you like this video and you think you want to try this as your side dish for your Thanksgiving meal, leave a comment down below. Hit like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And you can also follow me on Facebook, TikTok, Instagram, and Twitter. I guarantee this is going to be a crowd pleaser for your family and friends. Thank you for watching. God bless, and have a safe and great holiday season.